Hello everybody. Hi, I am Thekla Petridou, a Cypriot psychologist, YouTuber and an author. And today it's Friday, the 4th of September 2020, and this is our weekly video in English. Today's subject is motivational. You can do it. You can change yourself. You can get yourself out of the situation you are stuck in. Many people perceive themselves as being trapped for life in several difficult situations, in a job that the working environment is toxic, in relationships that there is no love anymore or there has never been, in family relationships which are dysfunctional, malfunctional, and cause them unhappiness. Many people believe that it's not easy for them to change their lives, that it's not easy to make their lives better. In several traditions, luck has been characterized as a factor which has no connection whatsoever with the person. In many Asian, especially traditions like Greek ancient tradition, for example, people are believed to be born with their luck. What their life would be like is premeditated. It's already decided by the gods that this person will have, an example, a very happy and fulfilling life. He will be rich, she will be famous, or she will be ruling her country or the world, or the other person is an unlucky person. He's not gonna have too much money, too much success. He's gonna be unhappy. He won't be able to thrive in life. Psychology as a social science does not believe in fate, that people's fate is predetermined. What is really predetermined in everybody when we are born is the family we are born into and the genes we carry with us. There is some truth to it. Some people are lucky enough to be born in families that are loving and affectionate, with parents who are communicative with their children, who are psychologically educated and socially educated, or even also academically educated, and are able to provide their children with the tools to live a happy and functional life. Some people, though, have the misfortune, in brackets, the misfortune to be born in dysfunctional families where they are not able to receive love, they are not able to receive communication from their parents, affection, and have difficulty to enter life without any tools, without any tools for emotional and psychological survival. And also some people are happy enough, are lucky enough to be born with genes that do not predispose them for depression or anxiety or any other genetically predisposed condition. And some other people are unlucky enough to be born with a genetic disorder or with genetic predispositions for health issues, either physical health or mental health issues. This is the only thing that we can call luck or fate. The genes we come in the world with and the family we are born in. But this video is not for infants and newborn babies. This video is for adults or teenagers, people old enough to be able to understand that no matter what our life has been until now, no matter the difficulties we have faced in our lives, no matter how unlucky, in brackets, we were in terms of in which family we were born, or what genetic hereditary tradition we brought with us, no matter that, we can still alter our lives for the better. It is very common for people nowadays to believe that it's difficult to change a situation that has to do with people, emotions, feelings, and relationships. We are going through a global values crisis. Even Western and Eastern societies are going through a phase of change. Economic crisis has affected Western world too much. Eastern world has had its difficulties for a long time now. And human relationships are even more difficult than ever before in this postmodern society. Postmodern for us, for other areas of the planet, maybe still be modern. We have come to a point that most of us believe that it's difficult to change our lives, that it's difficult to achieve a better future, that our times are not a good times for people to thrive. And many people who've gone through difficulties find themselves unable to even visualize or dream about a better future, about a better life, about a better quality of life. It's easy and it's common to allow ourselves to feel trapped and feel that our fate has been sealed since we're 30 years old, 20 years old, 40 years old, 45 years old, 50, 60 years old, and we haven't managed to fulfill our dreams, we might as well leave them and live our life in misery. I strongly believe that every day can be the first day of the rest of your life. I know that this is a cliche. I know that this is a phrase that many people use, but I really do believe, and I have the clinical experience to back it up, that if one person decides to take their fate in their own hands, they are able to do so. And today, we have a lot of information from psychology, from philosophy, from psychotherapy, from human culture on how to better our lives. You are not alone. You are not the only person on earth who feels alone, who feels miserable, who feels that you haven't succeeded in life. All of us, no matter at what age we are, we haven't fulfilled all the dreams we thought that we have, that we would be able to fulfill until the age we are. It's only human. It's only human to dream big, and it's only human not to be able to fulfill all the dreams. How do we focus on ourselves? How do we motivate ourselves to find the inner strength to better our lives, to change our lives, and to stop being stuck? First of all, we need to believe in ourselves and to believe that we have the ability to understand life differently, that we have the ability to change our view of the world. We cannot change the world. We cannot change how other people think, how other people feel, how other people behave, but we can change the way we interpret the world. I've read this book several years ago, which is called The Luck Factor, and it's a book that was written by a psychology professor who has made a lot of research. He has done a lot of research on luck factor. He took a huge sample of people. This was in the UK. Some thousands of people were the people who took part in his experiments. He took their psychological profiles, not he himself, he and his students, and he also made them play the lottery in order to see, to compare the psychological profiles with the people that were proven to be more lucky through their lottery draw. He has come to some conclusions. Which people are the lucky people? Lucky people are the ones who really believe that they are lucky, no matter what, no matter how many obstacles they find in life, no matter how many difficulties they have in their road, they keep believing that they are lucky. If you believe you are lucky, you become lucky at the end. Another factor, another luck factor, is how you treat life's difficulties. People who are lucky, they take every opportunity that comes into their way to turn it for their benefit, even if it is something that is not positive, like a divorce, for example. Divorce happens to you. Lucky people will take their divorce and use it for their benefit. Or you lose your job, you can take this ugly incident and turn it to your benefit if you see, oh, this is a very good opportunity for me to look for another career path. It's a good opportunity for me to try and explore my hobbies and explore other opportunities I have to make a living, even in a better environment. I have come to this, I have seen this in people's lives because I've worked for 20 years as a private psychologist in Cyprus, and the last 3 years I work through the internet, I'm writing books, and I usually reply to people's emails through videos on my channel. Some people that have managed to succeed in life, they have very difficult histories. They come from very raw family situations. Many people who are called survivors have survived difficult childhood. They have not been born with a lot of money, or if they were born in rich families, they might have abusive relationships, abusive parents. They might have difficulties. They might have had difficulties in school, or difficulties with their health. They might have been unlucky in their marriages. They might have divorces. They might have bankruptcy, or whatever difficult things in their lives. And on their way to overcome their obstacles, they became great. And I've seen other people that were blessed enough to be born in healthy family settings with a lot of genetic tools to their use, with good genes, good-looking people, healthy people, intelligent people that haven't gone through difficulties in life, and they do not use their potential. It's really strange, but it seems that the most difficult one person's life is, the more potential he or she has to achieve greatness. If you strive in order to overcome your difficulties, this motivation from within helps you to go several steps further. So having difficulties in life, having your heart broken, having a divorce, having being fired from your job, having a health issue can be used for your favor. If you decide so, if you change the way you view the world, if you change the way you view your life, if you see your life as a travel, as a way to go somewhere special. Our life is a journey. You travel this journey and you enjoy it along the way. Our life is not the destination. Our life is the journey to take us somewhere special. We don't know where we go when our life finishes. We will find out if we go somewhere or not. But what we really know for true is that people who enjoy the ride, people who enjoy the journey of life, people who are willing to take risks in order to better their life, they have happy lives. And according to the Boston study, the famous study conducted in Boston by Harvard University and the people that worked with, has revealed the secret to happiness. The secret to happiness is meaningful relationships. Not many relationships, not money, not fame, not wealth, but meaningful connections. People who have meaningful connections in their lives, who invest in themselves and their in and in their relationships with other people that have meaning are the people who are happy. So by being pretty or handsome, you cannot be happy. By having money, you cannot be happy. By having fame, you cannot be happy. By having strong, meaningful connections, you can be happy. The first strong, meaningful connection we need to establish is with ourselves, with ourselves. We need to start loving ourselves and start taking responsibility of ourselves. You are responsible for yourself. You are responsible to motivate yourself, to alter your life, to better your life. You are responsible to motivate yourself to live a healthier life. You are responsible to take yourself to a psychologist's office and have therapy if you need so. You are responsible to take your medication if you are on some medication. You are responsible to look for your health. You are responsible to take care of yourself. Nobody else is. You are an adult. Not even your parents, even if they are in their 60s or 70s and they are young and youthful, are not responsible for you, nor your husband, nor your wife, nor your partner, nor your lover, neither your children. Only you is responsible for yourself. Only you is responsible for your happiness or your unhappiness. I know that this sounds a little bit poetic and a little bit out of reality, but trust me, I'm talking from experience, clinical experience and personal experience. Our difficulties, our most dark moments in our lives, the moment you feel that you've lost every hope, the moment you think that your life is finished, that might be the moment that your life is beginning, if you really, 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 really wish to alter your life. I have this story to share with you. I'm not seeing people anymore. As I said earlier, I'm writing books and I make YouTube videos. But some people share with me their stories. There was this lady who shared her story with me a year ago. She's a young professional woman who has a dark secret. She found herself at a point in her life to be in desperate need of money that she didn't need for herself. She used to help other people that she cared for, and she found herself trapped in sex work. Very intelligent woman, very educated woman, very intuitive woman. And she wrote an email to me to ask my opinion about her psychotherapeutic sessions she had with somebody. And I responded to her. I told her my opinion. She asked for my opinion as a psychologist about how a psychotherapeutic relationship should be and the barriers of psychotherapeutic relationship, and we started talking via email. And I asked her, "Do you like your life?" She wrote back, "No, I detest my life. I do not like my life the way it goes on." And she's also very good at writing, and she sent me some piece of her writing, which was how should I say? It was groundbreaking. A groundbreaking way of writing about her story, of how she lived her secret life, her parallel life of working as a sex worker in a society that nobody knew, nobody could understand that she had that dark secret. I was very touched by her story. And we had some email conversations, and I told her that if you really, really, really want to change your life, you will be able to do it. And I'm very happy because these days she emailed me and she told me that a series of unthinkable events happened, which seemed to be very negative events in her life. I will not say no more in order not to disclose any aspect of her identity. Some bad things happened in her life, and she had to to be hospitalized, and this left her out of business. I mean, she couldn't do her business. And when she returned back, she had job offerings that were good enough for her so as to drop that parallel life, a drop that dark life of working as a sex worker. Of course, she will continue her psychotherapy. She will not drop therapy now that she, her life has turned around and she's no longer a sex worker. But it was really, really, really very inspiring. And she wrote to me, I wanted so much to change my life. I wanted so much to get out of this net. I wanted so much not to be a sex worker anymore. But I couldn't see the way. But I kept wanting it and I kept wishing for it. And you helped me, she wrote, by writing to me that you accepted me the way I am and that you understand that anybody could have come to my position given the circumstances of my life. And you gave me hope when you said, because I wrote to her in an email, you can change it. I'm not telling you change it now, but please do. Please change in your brain. Please believe that you can do this change. She believed and she did it. If she could do it, we all can. We can all change our lives. And this is a true story. I know many more other stories of people who believed in change, who motivated themselves, and they managed to reverse their lives and better their lives and move on from a stuck situation. I'm 45 years old. I don't know how old each and any of you are. I have 45 years of life behind me. If I look back in my life, I can see many opportunities where, if I had the right mindset, I could have changed my life radically and better it. When I was 15 years old, when I was 18 years old, when I was 20 years old, when I was 22 years old, when I was 25 years old, when I was 30 years old, if I had the right mindset. The right mindset is something that you decide. You want to change your life. If you really want to change your life, you can. You can motivate yourself and better your life. I wish to all of us to have the right mindset, the positive mindset to change our lives, to motivate ourselves to change our life. I kiss all of you. Have a lovely weekend, everybody. Bye. See you next Friday.